put the string over here. And then let's see how it goes. Big end in.
Big end in.
Well, it maybe doesn't matter. Do you think it matters if big end in or not?
In this case, I'd probably put the small end up and let it overhang.
Now, that's an oyster mushroom. Yeah, it's an oyster mushroom. Oh, yeah, yeah, that's good. So, you're staying. Oh, Jim, you ruined it.
You wouldn't want to use that.
You can probably cut a green one in as thick as like this and get a good solid one. But you figure this is that inner space is defining how much room you have. It might be enough for 2 feet. If you're using smaller ones for the siding.
Fine.
Gary, yeah. You get your saw. Let's cut a log that we'll use for our ridge pole. That would be good.
That's a good example, yeah. You guys. You want to make sure your ridge pole is strong. Strong as a piece.
Build up the base. You made little beds. Okay, I'm sorry, you watched the guys. Okay. Jim is the chief engineer, so follow whatever Jim says.
If you want to make it low, you should go in the lower floor there.
What do you say? If a lower shelter is easier to cover and insulate, higher one, steeper, harder to cover, but sheds the rain better. So what does the chief engineer say?
Well, you know, if you don't have much time, and warmth is really the main concern, you want it as small as possible.
Okay, how much does it
take to fill out a room? That's one choice. If you have more time, I like more space.
Okay, but Jim, is that enough room to get a couple people in?
I would go for more space.
We can move it
that way. I'm not able to have a fire, I'll make it as small as possible.
Yeah, let's move it that way. It's a
survival structure. But if it's more hanging out, I'll make it bigger.
So what do you think? Does that give you enough room? See, we may want to jack this up a little bit. Keep a low ceiling, but prop this up with another log. Because, see, that's not a lot of space. But if you do this, look what you have to work with. It opens it up considerably. So we need a log, a forked log, or that we can prop this and we'll pick this up with. Okay, what was that movie in where the Nazis were taking the Jews in the jungle in the forest?
Defiance.
That's a good one to watch, too. So this is a low ceiling. You think that's going to be okay, Jim?
Yeah, I mean...
Mind we got to build up a little bedding underneath?
They're all okay. It just depends on what your purpose is. Like
right.
If you want a quickie...
You think that's too low? You don't think that's too low?
No, I've had them lower.
If you have any complaints in the sector's done, you never heard the chief engineer was.
I don't bump my head.
He doesn't want to bump his head.
Biggest
you're not standing up in these. These are glorified
people. You can crawl inside and sleep.
You can crawl inside and sleep because these are not living themselves.
Yeah. Like your mummy bed.
Okay, okay.
The warmer you are, okay. The more open space, the more cold air you have. You have more and more. But if you want comfort, you make a fire, make it taller.
Survival thing, you just want to
we could cut this and bend it and stand it up that way. Right? We don't even...
Usually the first thing we'll do is put down a lot of dust material to insulate from the rain. Because that's where all the cold rest in the air. We'll put down dust material, leaves and debris, maybe sometimes this thin.
Right here?
Foot.
Oh,
yeah?
Yeah,
even more. So ideally you set this down. We need to do a rail, you know, because of rain and rest, the rails down and then the cross.
But if it's attached, it's going to be more solid, isn't it? And leave it attached and just bend it? That's what I'm trying to do.
No, it's not going to be that much. It's okay. It's up to you.
He's the chief engineer.
What are you doing?
I was thinking of bending this.
That fork there is going to be the one that holds this like that.
Yeah.
Why don't we do that?
Okay, we'll do that.
Sure. Do you want a longer one?
I think this is actually, we can use that. I think this is going to work.
Yeah, so we'll probably cut that in pieces.
So what we, ideally, what we want to do, guys, when we put our rails together, the siding, you want them as tight together as possible. You can't always find straight pieces, but that's the ideal. So your bigger pieces first, and then progressively your smaller pieces. And then when we put the siding on, like if we're going to put grass or whatever, we want all the branches to be pointing down this way, so that when the rain comes in, the water it drips off. In other words, put them on this way, and they'll drip right into our shelter.
They're
not like
shingles. Yeah, we're going to be behind that. Okay, so that's the shape of our shelter. Pretty exciting, huh?
If you have a luxury, you have a saw, that's great, but if you don't, then you find places to break your thing to size. Like between branches or between rocks and things like that. You know.
See, we have to definitely stabilize this at the end. We don't want this guy wobbling. And then this could be dug out a little bit to have room. So let's, you guys are all standing around watching.
Okay.
We need, okay, let's start leaning stuff up on both sides here. And then we're going to find the opening will probably be up there. This basically has to be covered like the peak of a roof.
Christopher,
we've used lots of a room, don't you?
Okay. Very brilliant.
Okay, just put it in the middle of it. So, okay, but it still wobbles.
Yeah.
So once we start leaning.
Yeah,
we can do just leaning off of both. It'll get stable real quick.
Taller?
Now, see, if you have this angle, if it's the longer, it's better. Get more fuse. Yeah. So I would go at least that long. This can go down here. So stabilize here.
The lock is perfect. It looks like the lock is there.
And that's keeping it in
there. So we ought to put that in the distance.
Or see if you get another branch at that back end. So it can't drop down. See, that's the problem with that. That's two trees that are splitting open. This wouldn't have done that. But again, that's how we're following the guidance.
No, well, that's because I was using it to break this. I was spread. Yeah. It would spread along.
But it shouldn't have been starting leaving it.
No.
This is more like a one or two person, so we don't want it this wide.
I think let's keep it that wide. Because even for two people, it's low. Once you move some of the soil around on the inside.
Okay, how about wider on that side? Maybe not too wide on
that side. That's fine. And also, before we get it too close up, at that level, we want to decide how we want to modify this. Bus bar. Why don't you start doing that, Jim? And then, because then you can put leaves and stuff. It's going to be very muddy without having a layer of the root, or like a layer of the window, or layer of the window down. I would do that over here. It's wet there. Yeah.
Is that the idea? You want to take.
Jim, are you doing you're doing as fine of a job as is possible? Gary, what have you doing such a good job?
Shelter.
thinking about it and worrying about it, right? Making an Indian fort, right?
By the way, you guys moving this mud reminds me that it's a nice way to seal the bottom, to pack in some dirt.
Around the bottom.
Yeah. And also, we could dig a trench.
By the time we're done, this has to be like completely sealed as much as possible. Smaller and smaller stuff. Eventually, you can throw all this little stuff on it. It's a stick. Layers. Leaves, everything. Branches, whatever, bark. Whatever we can find.
Bigger pieces, smaller pieces, and leaves and stuff, and then you can start again. Just keep repeating. The more windows are stunned, the more.
Insulation.
Generally, we wouldn't make a shelter. We just are raining right now. We wouldn't make a shelter.
Unless you really know the weather well and it's a short window.
Framework. But eventually the whole framework has to be covered with smaller than all, any of that leaves and junk there. All of that stuff is covered because you almost have to, as airtight as possible. Ideally it's dark when you're inside, but that's, you rarely achieve that unless you spend a lot of time.
Do this side, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, we want this open so we'll be able to get the jump.
Okay.
Got plenty of stuff to lay in on that.
Yeah, Jim's just making it so you have a somewhat suitable bedding. And realistically, if you were going to spend the night here, you need to do as much work on that bedding so you can lay there and not get all wet. Because Rick doesn't like you wet when sleeping.
Right? Or being downhill.
So that'll take you to work out. That's not a good deal. Huh? Feet would be down here, your head is up there. So he's leveling it up pretty good. And see, for this, for that matter, another option, if it's not a problem, you make a fire in here. You have dry it out, and you could almost have a reflector shelter.
Yeah, there's all these.
Hold stuff in there too. Now that might be too early for us to add that, but we don't have to stay all the same way. See, that'll help hold things. Because these walls have to be thick by the time they're done. We have to pack a lot of stuff in there. Billy doesn't like being cold at night when he's sleeping, right, Billy? Both sides, but where Jim is just having us stay over here because he's working. We can't get in there if we fill it up.
Yeah,
if we want to
in this whole area.
Yeah, we fill it in as much as we can. We'll go to that side. So we're gonna have to create some kind of a bedding too. Do you see all those arugos that are cut as we walk in here? Yeah, we should line those up real close together. Do a couple layers of them. Either way. One way, then the other way, because we probably want to have two or three layers of these. Long way is probably easier.
You guys remember all those thistles? What we saw, the big field of dry thistles?
Yeah. The other way is the other one.
Whoa. put them on each other.
Yeah.
You know what people used to talk about as the next big disaster back in the 1970s? Wasn't global warming, it was an ice age. So if you had the East Coast thing not melting, there'd be a lot of people would adapt, but a lot of billions of people would move. Not say that, people live in Alaska, snow all the time. But if there was some kind of a catastrophe, you had to go on the move quickly. Shelter is not the biggest problem. The biggest problem is groups have to deal with. There's food, toilets. You need toilets. You want privacy somehow. You have to figure that out on the road. And you want to deal with medicine. Food, medicine, and hygiene are your big deals. Not shelter. Children can figure this out in the backyard. Right? You're here because you're all grown up and you forgot how to think like a child. See what Jim says, because he's still working on that. I would just assemble them over on Jim's side.
You can just step on them and break them.
Maybe trim them to a set length. But until Jim is ready with the inside, we don't want to put it inside yet. We will have to create a floor of lots and lots of those aluminum.
These guys, ideally, instead of one's on the ground here, the other one's on the ground back here. Ideally, they'll be evenly, like up. See, like this one's way back here. Bring it in.
That's the floor you're saying, right?
Yeah. Bring the floor in, match.
You want us to do that? Move them all in?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, so work with Jim. Have one base, move them up higher, so then he can secure the bottom.
Bring them in for where the closest ones are.
Okay, so
they'll all be kind of even.
Okay.
There will be an opening, yeah. Maybe not a door like you're used to thinking of it, but there will be an opening. We'll call it the door. Would you like to spend the night in this? Maybe not the whole night, spend the night in here? Have a little fire. Get to listen to the coyotes and the homeless guy singing. Good night. After they have a few beers, start singing down here. Big margaritas.
We can cut this one up to size for somebody. Okay. So on. Seeing how crooked this thing is sideways.
This thing won't think it's
straight. When they really get compiled like that, they might not break this one off. So it would be easier to get it in there separately.
What was that movie about the Russian dating where these cold outs hang
paint?
Red Dawn. That's an interesting movie. Facing the wrong way. If people haven't been too concerned about the top and the bottom of the sticks, Jim.
Well, yeah, when you start living in these things, you guys, then it's going to be more, you're going to pay more attention.
In this area,
I would have built my shoulder above
that.
Well, we
right.
Still pretty cool.
You still have it. You would have done what? See, there's always Monday morning
quarterback.
What I would have done.
No, I mean, with this question, I would have.
You did?
Well, we did. There's something to consider when Jerry just said, warmer weather, it doesn't matter when it's warmer, then it's probably good. But in cold weather, the higher you're off the ground, the more clear you have.
Yeah.
gotta insulate it.
Okay, we should still be putting sticks on. We need lots of sticks. Why don't you work on the inside, Jim? Because we can start to lay the window down if you think the bed of the flooring is done.
Okay.
I'd like there to be a couple layers of a window one way and then maybe another.
Are we going to do the window with the rail? Or just with the mat?
I think it's easier under the circumstances to do like a mat all one way and then maybe the other way and then maybe the third way, even three layers. There's plenty of a window here.
If we have,
like to see this.
If we have something big like this, or maybe not even twice this diameter, we could kind of have a rail of this go on each side of this one, and then just go across.
We could try that. What do you want to do? We could try that. We have to do a lot of cutting. We have to have several layers of the window to make that work. That's what I was saying. Under the circumstances here, it might be just good to make layers of mat and mats.
Okay, let's do that.
Because I think also the window may not support as well as like willow branches or whatever. Do you think it would?
Yeah, well, I was thinking we'd use more willow branches and stuff both ways. But that
might take a little time. Time is not really the problem. Why don't we try the railing? Try your idea, but maybe smaller. Okay, do you understand what we're talking about?
Yep.
We have two side logs inside, like the sides of a bed. Then we put a window across. You're sleeping on the window, and you're off to the ground a few inches, right, Rick?
Yeah.
What do you think about that idea?
Can somebody find a...
I'm glad we have his approval.
Look for a couple of rails approximately this diameter and approximately the length of shelter.
We can cut a few, Jim.
Just two is all we need. Just one rail on this side, one rail on that side, and then we'll put the cross rails on it.
What about this side right here?
That would be good. It doesn't. That would be good. That's got a big curve on it though. Well, that's okay. It'll lay sideways. We can lay it sideways. Can see why we didn't want to put these in.
That's what I was wondering about.
Dad, you don't need a big one.
Huh?
And let's take that.
Dad, you already got a big one.
Got a big one?
Yeah.
So Jim is picking a few out just so we have access to the inside. I hope you are not clear exactly what we're doing. Come over and have a look. We're going to create a bed, two sides, and fill it in with the windows. Most of this room, though, will have to be cut down to a smaller length.
Oh, not bad.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is going to do this really well.
And in fact, the railing could also be partly willows, straight willows.
This one, too.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I'm wondering, well, we can, I don't think so. I'm wondering if we can put this one on.
Near the box. Go ahead. Or leave so he's not uncomfortable lying on it. Rick, what are you doing over there? What are you doing? Oh, you can cut it? Dad? I got bended.
Okay, maybe we'll reverse this. Put the pad in.
Your head's going to be to your left, right, Jim?
Yeah.
Are you cutting this with a saw right now, Gary?
No.
Oh,
Oh, yeah.
For yourself?
No. For the filter.
Where's the other one that you had? The other axe?
It's on my backpack.
Okay.
Is that the gray one?
No. It fell.
Doable, but it's not easy.
Oh,
What is that?
For the roof. Yeah.
Oh.
No, I don't think it is.
Like yeah, it looks like it.
Work area.
Came from the bamboo factory right there.
Well, this is
Yeah. Anyone need some cordage? Oh no, umbrella grass is it's good. Yeah.
You have?
Yeah.
Will it last?
I think somebody's going to get way too cozy here today. They're going to make me stay home from somebody.
A little like that.
I might get home back.
Like Rick with a big butt. It's real heavy.
Gary needs to watch himself, right?
That's pretty easy.
I tie it like this.
I think it's all things.
Oh, I think it's make quarters.
Well, you can use it as
good fibers are kind of loose.
Yeah.
This is still a long way to being able to sleep in tonight. Just like we created the initial framework, but as these things usually go, Katrina's level is maybe 80% boredom. So everybody else kind of rises about 50%, and we go on to the next thing. And you get the general idea. We're using the Katrina standard. So if we rise above the 50% level of the Katrina standard, then we all go on to the next thing.
How much could you get that?
No good support.
I'm very thinking of that.
Sleep it up just like that. You can actually leave the forward or nose. Yeah, yeah. That's not
that stuff on it.
But just so you know, if you start to make one of these walls have to be fixed if you want. If you want to get off the ground, you can pull it direct. If you want lots of insulation around you. Generally speaking, primitive shelters don't put fire in it. It's smaller than 2 flammable. Because of fire on the outside, small, okay, and then heat rocks and bring them inside. In fact, in this shelter, the unique thing about it, now that there's a basement, so to speak, you could actually dig out, hollow a little thing under here and put a few rocks underneath, let them radiate during the night. You could actually do that. Jim could create a little compartment, you could pull some Marundo off to the side, put a hot rock in there, let it radiate. You could have a little tiny fire here. Get to find some rocks, which are hard to find.
I would sleep in there.
Yeah.
You're up off the ground.
Really another good thing we do, we got to get the plants all the way around. Yeah. And then
but I would say the bedding is not complete, in my opinion.
It needs to actually. More than just a little strength.
We kept it open so we can work it only.
But we got to close it.
We want to close it.
Yeah, remember. Cool.
You're lying here. This is nice.
It's really
nice.
How comfortable it is. Put that in your catalog, Carl. He is amazed at how comfortable it is.
Give it her to my dad.
Okay, we need a.
That's my answer.
We need a quilt in here.
We got a blanket.
You guys want to pay attention to this? Ideally, you're going to start
laying your leaves and stuff in to the bottom. And then your next layer would be above that, so this leaf, they would overhang this leaf.
Like a skirt.
And you start at the bottom and secure that pretty good for a good layer at the bottom. And then the next layer.
Well,
layer.
So you can actually
have it. Oh, yeah, the bathroom should be right there.
The bathroom is out there. Not in there.
Yeah, we can do
this.
Ready? Really, really super good.
I think I'll make an editorial decision, an executive decision, and this is probably, we can go on to the fire making, because I think everybody understands the principle.
It's a custom living.
So try your bed.
More than
merrier. Go on more bed. Go there. Go try your bed. It's your arm.
Very nice.
Go. That wants to take the turn, guys.
And again, it's half and the other half.
Chris is going there and lay down. Go down with the picture on your bed.
So this is your basic lean-to.
Pretty heavy bed is on me. I'm a little scared. This is a video. I just moved
this up. It's nice, isn't it?
Hey, Kate, are we going to see this on YouTube tonight? get Billy in there with you.
Bottom half of your legs are just turning into the bed.
You can give your Kate's rule of three for what you need in the woods. Have your knife, fire starter, and Billy.
There you go.
It's on tape?
Yep.
Yeah, so now
it's... She makes you look like a recliner.
Yeah.
Comfortable.
Where's your pillow? You need a pillow, too.
Oh, yeah, we don't have a pillow. Can I
fold a little? Tina, you have Billy lay down there in the top. That's your pillow. Right, Billy? Your belly is your pillow.
You don't want to catch one of those the wrong way.
That's it right there. That's the pose.
Okay, there you go. Okay.
Work the camera. I don't know. Put him on the roof. Put him on the side.
I got lots of Lestrip, but I'm going to send them to Chris.
This one's better than Lestrip, isn't it?
They're always better than last time.
Yeah.
You can take more pictures if you want.
Carissa.
Hold on. It's two people here.
So we spent barely an hour.
Yeah.
Okay, but realistically, a small group, 2 to 3 hours.
Again?
See on both sides.
Single person is probably half a day or a day project.
And this is probably better. I mean, my initial decision was just make a shelter, she said, to do it. But now here's the real circumstance. It's wet.
Are you eating and talking at the same time?
Please excuse my rudeness and my callousness and crudeness.
You're even looking, I could tell you.
Sorry about that. I rarely do that.
You're multitasking. All right.
Is that your way of saying you'd like a little? Is it a buffalo drink?
Oh, no thanks.
So you should all.
Sure. It'd take a little more time.
Yeah, we can even take wind into account with this. We just took the trees that we had. But the wind is really going to be over us in here. You're not going to feel much wind in here at night. Now, do you think it's going to be easy to find that purpose
like
we just go around? Because we're just going through a thicket here, aren't we?
No, I went down there and checked.
We're not.
Okay, so we're going to go. So I think what we'll do next, those tables are probably not occupied. It did say no fires.
Why not?
So we're going to work on them, but put them out right away so we're not hassled. We don't want smoke and stuff around.
Here you go.
But we'll go up either to the barbecue areas or to the tables, and we'll do some work there.
Yeah, you will.
Try a number of different methods.
You live and have to live in the park because you were bad.
There you go.
It's
lively and comfortable.
There you go.
I'm not going to laugh.